my car.
Watch your ass these days! I suppose this is what we must expect when these events are open to the public.
Now, is this the scene where you get the vaccine?
Who's he? It's Allison.
That delinquent? That's Wade Walker from over at Mervo. He was in all the papers for joyriding.
Some call him CryBaby.
CryBaby! He's the most popular loner in school.
Oh, Lenora, would you stop following me? I was hoping you'd take a hint when I ran you over.
I'll always treasure that moment.
Popular? Ha! Everyone knows his commie parents both got the electric chair. They were innocent. They were framed. And someday, I'm gonna clear my family's name. I've been reading law books.
I forgot the Walkers had a son.
How are you gonna clear anything acting the way you do? You're nothing but a low-down, swivel-head drape. What are you doing here anyway? Go back where you belong. I belong wherever I happen to be. We got just as much right to be here as any of you.
Yeah, he's a drape, but he's not a ghost.
Yeah, he don't know me.
None of us do.
Yeah.
We got a lot of dancing to do.
Even know how to talk in private. Huh?
That is so mysterious.
You're nothing but a misfit. You people here don't know who I am. Nobody gets me. CryBaby, some nickname. What are you? Delicate? Ha ha! Nobody gets my nickname. So I'll make it clear. It's meant to be ironic. Cause I won't shed a tear. But irony is lost on you people here. Wait a minute, wait a minute. If nobody gets you, what do you call that terrible trio? Nobody gets the reason I'm the leader of a drape gang. I ain't gonna lie.
They don't lie.
They don't give me either. But at least they try.
They really try.
They don't give me. Sometimes neither do I. Make me sad. Since I'm still I was born, I ain't never been got. I guess that you could call me a dead man. I really don't get. Yeah, I get that a lot.
Nobody in the same.
Nobody in the same.
Sad to say.
It's just the truth. Not much of that going around.
And yet, how beautiful.
Allison, stop sympathizing with that thoroughly unsuitable young hellion. Pardon my French. You don't even know him.
Oh, I'm Wade.
I'm Allison.
Ah, see, now we know each other. Ipso facto.
Ipso facto?
I'm a singer, at least I want to be.
I'm a good girl, but I don't want to be.
This is my cousin Pepper.
I'm 16, single, and pregnant.
This is my best friend, Dupree.
Woo!
And now these are my other gang members. Mona?
Oh! Call me Hatchface.
I think I saw her picture in National Geographic.
This is the physically gifted Wanda.
I'm in charge of creating a distraction. Here's your wallet. Oh, I see these are yours, too. Hatchetface looks the horror and horrible. Thanks, Wanda. I'm ugly on the inside, too.
Hatchetface is a walk on the wild side. Not to her jewelry.
I'm the Nora. I'm CryBaby's destiny.
She's not with us.
Pleased to meet you. I admire your freedom.
And I admire your open mind.
Stop it! Stop it! You are turning this carnival into a circus!
Turn of a flipper!
Allison, this is not a mixer.
Oh, grandmother, please. I wish for once you'd let me meet new people.
Drapes are not people, per se. Now, everyone, get in line to get your shot!
Just to be safe, I'm gonna go back for seconds.
That's the spirit.
I know you don't know me, man, but I tune an engine real fine, and I sing pretty good, too. Look, I would like to get to know you and your daughter here.
She's my granddaughter.
He's burned you up to get
I don't
to...
care what he's talking about.
Yeah, blame a guy for trying.
And one sings well.
I like the way you sing.
Allison, go let the niceness immaculate. Immaculate.
Young man,
I cannot ask you to leave a public park. And while I am sure you do sing, as you put it, good, please, stay away from my granddaughter. You're simply not our kind, dear.
I'm sorry, my grandmother is so rigid.
No, that's not your fault.
Next!
Hey! Don't be scared.
Enough.
I like that. Beautiful and brave.
Tenderness, I feel. Oh!
Exactly like this.
Squeaky clean, that's what they call us. Our thoughts are pure and our grooming is flawless. We're well-bred, well-mannered, and, well, just nice. And when you rub our hair, it sounds like mice. Squeaky clean, down to our marrow. We're very straight and extremely narrow. Our drink of choice is Listerine. It keeps our insides extra squeaky clean. When vulgar people curse, hiss, hiss. When heathens grunt and stammer, we don't know which is worse, tut-tut, their language or their grammar. They neither show refinements nor an ounce of self-restraint. They may think it's proper English, but it's not.
Most assuredly, it's not.
Yes, I'm squeaky clean, but ever so lonely. Wish I were squeak and in your ears only. Cause gosh, I think you're peachy keen. When I see you, I feel extra squeaky clean.
Of standing and up to snuff. I know one kiss from him would be enough. Someone squeaky clean, shiny and sterling, like a baton that needs some twirling. That's why I use Vaseline, so my hands remain unshaped and squeaky clean.
She makes my spirit rise, she sets my soul a-spinning. It's bluer in her eyes than any pool I've been in. The two of us together, such a perfect match. If she'd only say she'd have me, what a catch!
What a catch!
Squeaky clean, promise me this, I'll get
looking well, see? I think you remember my gang.
Oh, I'm sorry, but you weren't invited.
Oh, relax, Countess. We're here to offer moral support.
And cover his back.
You tattoo truant? This is for members only.
Honestly, why must the backward always be so forward?
No offense, we thought if we made the effort to show up, you'd give in and let us join the party. Maybe sing something specially for you, Allison. Ha! You don't want to hear this kind of music? It's indecent. They don't even allow it on the radio. Here's what I think of your jukebox junk.
Open! Oh, oh, rule one in etiquette, no killing.
How dare you fancy pants freak!
Oh, no, wait, oh. Wait, that ain't the answer.
You don't own me. I have a right to hear CryBaby sing. Allison.
I would hit you back in good. I mean, well. But I don't believe in violence.
Ooh, a pacifist, just like his old man.
But I love it. Look, we're just as good as any of you.
I did.
This is a free country.
Yes, this country is free. But this country club isn't.
Can't they be my special guests?
Oh, great! All of them at her.
Same here.
Ain't mine a double. I'm drinking for two. Oh.
You could sign for them.
I could. I could also allow wild birds to nest in my hair. The answer is no.
That means go. Well, looks like we can't get together here, Allison, but if you want to come, we will be singing tonight out at Turkey Point. Oh. It's the big jukebox jamboree.
Turkey Point?
The redneck Riviera.
That part of the woods is just filthy.
I'd like to CryBaby, but don't they find a lot of dead bodies dumped out there?
That was weeks ago.
It's impossible. I'm responsible for Allison's safety.
She'd be safe with me. I promise you that. A Drake's promise? That's worthless.
Yeah. CryBaby always keeps his word.
Grandmother, please. I'm old enough to make my own decisions.
You don't think you are.
Can't I just go?
No. Mr. Walker, I wish you well at your jamboree. Was it? But I must insist that you and your retinue leave at once.
Hey, no, that is not necessary. But come on, girls. Let's get back to the right side of the tracks. Oh!
Thank you. everybody's disappearing. Wonder why they're racing now so fast. Judging by how fast they're heading, you would think it's Armageddon. Now they're gone and we're alone at last. So sad to see the party wiped out.
No one joint that's just outside of town.
Never to loosen up. It's not upper class. upper class. Upper ass! You're a high class girl from a high class world. You eat your salad with a salad and fork. And you've been so well trained to be refined and restrained. Since the day you were delivered by the high class door. Leave that world behind you, girl.
Baby, I've got a screw loose. Baby, 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 baby
chewing tobacco. Oh, baby, I could do this for hours.
Whoa, hey, hours? I'm not looking for a long-term relationship.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, did you bring protection?
I got a gun.
This is the most romantic night of my life. The stars littering up the sky. The moonlight shining on all that chrome in the junkyard.
Robitussin?
Some things I'm not seeking. I've never felt better in my whole life.
This is my special, secret place. I've never brought anyone else here. I come here to think and be alone with my isolated solitude by myself.
I think I understand your loneliness, CryBaby. I'm an orphan, too.
I didn't know.
Labor Day picnic, a freak croquet accident. I know how we orphans have special, more intense needs.
Oh, I've been saving it up for a girl like you, Allison. You're what the law books call my sine qua non.
Oh, wait. Were your parents really communists?
No, baby, no. They were pacifists. They never hurt anybody. A factory burned down, a watchman was killed, and they framed my folks because they were different. It's what they call circumstantial evidence. Is it okay with you?
Yes. This is all so new to me.
Oh, don't worry. You're safe with me. But if you're ready for something new, I know something that's really nice.
Yeah.
like you, Allison. And to show you my lack, there is something special I want to give you.
Oh, great, baby. Oh, what can be more special than what you just gave me?
It's in my guitar case back at the pavilion. You'll be safe here. I'll be back in a flash.
My shoulders standing well, 'cause baby I'm infected with your love. Baby, I'm infected with your love.
How you doing? You miss me?
Oh, my life. Only I didn't know it.
Here it is. The closest thing in the world I have to a treasure. I want you to have it.
Beautiful yellow toenail.
It's music shop. I had my initials in mind. WW on one side, and on the other, CB. Remind me to always be proud of who I am, even if nobody else understands.
I'll cherish you. Always. Will you place it next to my heart?
What do you mean?
I'm ready.
Anything to oblige a lady.
What's
going on? The pavilion's on fire!
Oh my gosh!
My guitar!
My bass!
Oh, my tambourine! My beautiful tambourine!
That place is like my home! That place is my home!
Allison! 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 What are you not wearing? Thank God I found you! Your grandmother asked me to come look for you, and it's a good thing I did. You could have been caught in that flea-bitten fire trap.
Well, I told you she would be safe with me.
Nobody's safe with you, you poorhouse pinko. Officers! Officers! Here he is!
Walker, what are you doing?
That's him. There's your man, CryBaby Walker, second-generation arsonist.
What?
He's the one that set that fire.
I don't believe it.
I saw him do it. I had just arrived, and he had a red can of gasoline.
We did find such an article.
No, that's crazy. I didn't set any fire.
Are you calling him a liar, Julie Ryder?
Well, why would I set fire to a place I love?
He doesn't have a reason. He's a psycho firebug, just like his nutcase parents, a congenital pyromaniac. He and his girl gang set fires just for kicks.
That is it, lying about women? Oh, forgive me, Allison, but that puts the fist in pacifist.
Let him go, you goddamn Nazi!
You preach to some violence, don't you?
No!
You're all under arrest.
What for?
Resisting arrest!
Thank you. our pubescent pre-judgmental court is now in session. Judge Igneous Stone presiding.
Order in the court! I said order in the court!
He's strict.
Well, the devil's charm bracelet. You are charged with arson, assault, resisting arrest, and drapery in the first degree. How do the so-called defendants plead?
I'm not guilty. Stand quiet and stun my guitar.
My drugs.
And my career.
Yeah.
Gangs have terrorized our fair city long enough.
If it please the court, we had nothing to do with this alleged malfeasance.
Yeah, we were too busy making out. Yeah, we're not criminals.
Are any of your parents here?
My parents are dead.
My parents are also dead. My parents told me to tell you they're dead.
Your Honor, I'm Wanda's father. And God knows, I'm trying to keep her upbringing antiseptic.
Daddy, you're humiliating me.
Dr. Woodward.
Oh, I'm not a doctor. I just love wearing medical whites.
You see, nonetheless, I am surprised to find a man who even appears to be a doctor, touched by this sordid episode. And your daughter is such a pretty girl, too.
Get it, Grandpa!
What about the Mona, Mound Larowski, is it?
That's me.
Oh, my God! What happened to your face?
There's nothing wrong with my face. I've got character.
Let me in.
Judge, you know Sunset in Hawaii yourself. I'm Mona's mom. Cigarettes? Get your cigarettes here. Hey, Mona, you're not smoking.
Sorry, Mom.
Mrs. Malnarowski, there is no smoking in this courtroom and certainly no peddling about.
Well, sorry. Just trying to make a living here.
Are you here to vouch for your daughter?
Yeah. I'm here to tell you to throw the book at her. I read your diary.
I was experimenting.
You
get her out of here.
Piece of trash. Just get out of my house.
Now then, Dupree, is it? Is that your first or your last name?
Whichever you like the least.
Sit down. Next, Allison Vernon-Williams.
Your Honor. There must be some mistake. Allison may have missed curfew, but I'm sure she committed no crime.
She's right, Judge. Let Allison go. She's innocent.
I didn't kick a cop in the nuts.
Scrotum.
Inadvertently, I'm sure. And you, Wade Walker, alias CryBaby, perpetual foster home runaway. You were the apparent ringleader of this gang of arsonists.
Look, they are no arsonists, and neither am I. But if you let them all go, I will take the full blame. Nolo contendere. I rest my case. Williams, I swear to you, the only thing that I am guilty of is loving your granddaughter.
Judge Stone, I wonder if we overlooked some good in this boy. He is at least polite.
Mrs. Vernon Williams, I have great respect for your elegance and sensitivity. I remember with pleasure how charmingly you presented your damning testimony at the trial of this hoodlum's incendiary left-leaning parent.
The killer peacenik sat.
That's enough. Judge, time to dip a bed. It was complicated. Please, couldn't we give CryBaby another chance?
I'm sorry, but it's clear to me that biological. Unfortunately, this young man was born to be bad.
No, he is!
That's why I can't hold you in contempt, of course.
Oh, contempt? You got it!
Serve 6 months in the Montrose School for underage female trash. Special cosmetic rehabilitation for Miss Mandarowski in the Institute's correctional surgery wing.
My baby will be born a convict! What am I supposed to tell all the possible fathers?
Your newborn will be placed in foster care. Take him away! I remand you, whatever that means, to the custody of your upstanding and outstanding grandmother.
Oh, thank you, Judge!
Wade Walker, I sentence you and your friend Dupree to learn a useful trade at the Maryland Vocational Training Farm for wayward punks until you reach the age of 20. 9.
Whoa! No! I'm supposed to be Baltimore's next great DJ!
And I hereby confiscate all your property in Turkey Point for non-payment of city, state, and syndicate tax!
Whoa! How did I not do that?
Your Honor, that's cruel and unusual punishment!
Take them away!
I'm sorry!
Have mercy! You can't send Crybaby away! He's about to become the father of my child!
What? Crybaby?
Oh, no, she's making that up, Allison. She's crazy.
Am I? Did he take you to a special place, too? Where he never took anyone else? The old dock? And did he give you his only treasure? Something that looks like a yellow toenail, but it's not? It's actually a gold-plated guitar pick made special at Ted's music shop with WW on one side and CD on the other. Do you mind to be proud of who he is, even if nobody else understands? Like this one.
Crybaby, how could you?
Wait, I don't know how.
Mr. Walker, I trusted you were going to do the right thing and marry this girl.
That's what he promised me, Your Majesty.
Marry her? Never. Look, she don't mean a thing to me, Judge.
Oh, oh, typical. I don't want to believe it.
Allison, listen.
Crybaby. Look at you playing my arm with this! I never want to see you again.
No, don't say that! I think I'm gonna cry.
I spit on your tears.
I can't believe she cursed me.
I can't believe I kissed him.
Thank you.
like four hits and a miss.
That's wonderful, Baldwin. But I can't sing with you tonight.
Oh, it's not tonight. It's a month from now.
The 4th of July.
That's like square Christmas.
Well. Oh, come on, Allison. I need my best girl by my side when I achieve true greatness.
Oh, what's the matter?
Still carrying a torch for your old flame.
Hey!
What? No. Of course not. I am completely over constantly thinking about him day and night. I would be glad to sing with you, Baldwin. With all of you. It'll be just like it was before. It'll be good, normal fun. It'll be more average than ever.
Yay! My own special Juliet. See you at school tomorrow, I hope.
Bye, Baldwin. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
I wish I'd not sing the big square again.
Yay!
Now, darling, didn't I ask you never to have problems?
I'm sorry, Grandma.
Sweetheart, you've been behaving like this for weeks. Skipping school, sleeping late, you're letting yourself go. Yes, you shampoo, lather, and rinse, but you don't repeat. You've got to get hold of yourself.
It's not myself I want to get a hold of. Why did I have to fall for a two-timing drink from a family of communist pyromaniacs? Am I insane?
You're not insane, sweetheart. I understand why you feel the way you did. There were many charming things about it.
But he lied to me.
Don't judge him. Forgive him. And forget him. He was inappropriate. I'm sure there's someone very special in your future.
Baldwin.
I said special. Give your heart some time to think.
I wish I could believe you, Grandmother.
Dear little child, so naive and so gloomy, if she only knew the hands running through me, causing hesitance, reticence, fretfulness, skittishness, conflict, and woe. Woe, 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 woe.
Yes, I think so. And the court forced CryBaby to.
Oh, yes. Isn't it wonderful?
wedding on Father's Day. I'm choosing the ring.
Congratulations. For our wedding, my mother's going to be my best man. Then we're all going to honeymoon in the Virgin Islands.
Good for you.
What happened to your...
baby? It's Thursday. I'm not pregnant today. Well, happy shopping.
Thanks. A diamond for my darling.
A zircon for my icon.
Wait. You're marrying the guy I hate.
And you're marrying the girl I hate.
It's so beautiful. I've got a girl who loves me so. And happiness is all we know. We're so happy. And soon we'll be wed. Soon we'll be wed.
I've got a boy. I love him so. I'm never gonna let him go. Cause he loves me.
Really? Cause I've seen you.
He loves me! That's what I said.
I can see it so clearly. It's all in my head. And by, we'll settle down in some unethnic part of town. I'll make my bread. But she'll make the bread. Get it? Bread!
That's genuinely funny. We'll live inside a tin roof shack with 15 chimpanzees.
See it so clearly.
got you, buddy.
My son.
So you're his father?
Oh, that's enough!
Well, that's not what she said.
Oh, all right! Get back to your license plates! The rest of you, get in line! Hey! Get back to work! This ain't no hojos!
Right, baby, what are you doing? You're gonna get us the train duty again.
Man, I hate this. Freaking license plates for cars I'll never drive. For crime I didn't commit. God, no, that Allison hates me because of Lenora's crazy life.
Take it easy. We can keep our act clean, and maybe they'll give us time off for good behavior. I gotta get Turkey Point back before they build a sales robot on it.
Right, man. I gotta try and keep my cool.
Hey, you know what? It's the 4th of July. There's gonna be fireworks. You wanna listen to them on the radio?
Fireworks? On the radio? Man, that sticks.
If there's any soothing tunes on the dot.
That was Val Mooney and the Vinyllas singing You Put the Yes in Yesterday Night.
Oh, damn, that's square.
Now, joining us in our studios are two young high school songsters, Allison Vernon-Williams and Baldwin Blandish. I wish my listeners could see your cahute matching outfits.
Oh, you don't need to hear that. Fight!
Hello! We have a kind of extra special message for all of Baltimore. Well, most of Baltimore.
Hey, everybody. Tonight's a kind of grand opening at Star Spangled Funland.
It's Maryland's very first theme park. There'll be rides, candy, and us kind of singing together.
It's out off the interstate, just past the brand new slaughterhouse.
Well, then I understand you have a special message for Allison.
I sure do. Allison.
Yes?
I love you. Will you marry me?
He's got a ring, folks. Well, what's it gonna be, kid? Millions are listening.
No.
But she...
No. My fate is in your hands.
No, you can't.
Oh, Baldwin. Well, then...
No, don't do it!
Yes!
No!
Yes.
Oh,
what happened?
Oh, man, I've got to get out of here.
Hey, what's going on over there?
Sorry, officer.
I'm just a little upset. I don't mean to be rude. I hate to have my fury at the world be misconstrued. Just feel kind of bad, ever so sad. You see, I get that way when they take my girl and fry my mom and dad. If you see me fussing fridge, please don't take it as a threat. Sometimes I get a little upset.
Mister, you're cruising for a bruise,
slobbering for a clobbering. Requested no molesting.
I settle myself down a bit. I'm trying to relax. Actually, I'm still a little upset. Just a little bit irked at this entire world around which I am getting jerked. Guess that I'm not feeling so hot. I must have woke up on the wrong side of my rat-infested pot. I'm profounding my regret this entire tete-a-tete. Just sometimes I get a little upset.
Pick it up!
Excuse me, officer.
Plates are still coming, punks!
again.
All this love stuff makes me get.
Allison!
A little upset!
Morals.
mine. It's one's duty to set an example and to always comport oneself decently. A worthy endeavor at which I failed never. Well, not recently. But you see, I did something wrong once. One tiny thing wrong once. A small indiscretion, a minor transgression, I blundered town. Told a little white lie, just a scooch of the truth. But it did cause a scandal, and that was uncouth. Yes, I did something wrong once. One teensy thing wrong once. It was somewhat unseemly, not so, but extremely unravelable. Yes, I confess, I did something wrong once. Is it too late to make it right now? My life overall has been blameless. As I scan it through walls, do I find why even that weekend with Hitler?
Many years ago. especially for those of you here tonight who happen to be American, who know or envy an American, or who are just plain in America. Whiffles, forward, sing!
Washington, you weren't even Spanish. Thanks for our cuddly constitution, that's ever so complex. Full of bouncy little balances and cheeky little checks. It's got lots of swell amendments that guarantee our freedom. It's nice to know they're there in case we need them.
Hear ye, hear ye. We the Peppy, in order to form an okier-dokier union, establish funness, ensure local property values, provide for the common amusement, and promote the general use of fried dough as a healthful between meal snack, do ordain and establish this theme park as Star Spangled Funland!
So everybody join us on this July the 4th and say thanks for the nifty country. From the big folks in the south to their conquerors.
Inspection was to take
face. The factory burned to the ground, killing the watchman. It was Christmas Eve. The Blandishes were due at my home for carols and figgy pudding. They arrived late, reeking of gasoline. I didn't think anything of it at the time. With the war rationing, people drank anything they could get their hands on. Later, when they began to investigate the fire, Fred and Adele begged me to say that they had been at my house all evening. Well, it was wartime. I felt I had to stand shoulder to shoulder with my peers in class against the threat of anarchy and revolution. The police suspected a young pacifist couple who had demonstrated against war outside the factory the day before the fire, and I had to know them. Will and Ariel Walker claimed that they were home celebrating Christmas with their 7-year-old son at the time of the fire. But no one believed such a flimsy, far-fetched story. Fred Blandish testified that the Walkers had threatened to burn the factory down, and God forgive me, I confirmed his alibi. I needed to believe him. The Walkers were convicted of arson, murder, and treason. I realize now that they were innocent. Oh.
My family honor has been restored. Now, don't listen to her. She's a commie too.
But what about you and Lenora? Oh my goodness! What happened to all of you? Prison did it to us.
Whoa! Is that you, Hatchet Face? You're beautiful. Will you go out with me?
Drop dead, drip. I'm still ugly on the inside.
Just don't release us, and so we could probably find you here.
Wanda!
Yes. One night in solitary, I had a vision. So I took a correspondence course, nail by nail. So fed up with being hit on by everybody and his uncle. Maybe now that I'm a nun, I can get some goddamn peace and quiet.
That should do it.
Hey, Judge, can I keep my baby now?
Well, since you paid the debt to society you never owed, why not? And now, before I deal with the real matter at hand, listen to this. I hereby forgive all outstanding taxes on and restore all property rights for Turkey Point to Mr. Dupree W. Dupree.
Thank you, Judge. Woo! And with the insurance money, I'm going to rebuild Turkey Point. Yes! Even put up a broadcast tower and host my own radio show, y'all.
You're in a forgiving mood tonight, Igneous. Thank you for pardoning my damning false testimony.
It is statute of limitations. Anyhow, we can quid pro quo it later on at my house. Good deal.
Allison,
now, if there are no further interruptions,
The wedding is off! And don't even try to talk me out of it. I have the baby. I had it dozens of times. But I'm giving it up for adoption. There's someone else. I realized it was always you, Baldwin.
Huh? What?
Let's have Mr. Lincoln here marry us, Baldwin. Then you can kiss me with tongue.
I'll hand her over to the proper authorities.
I tried to tell you, Allison, there's never been anyone but you.
But how did you all get set free?
I can answer that. Earlier today, Mrs. Vernon-Williams overheard Baldwin bragging to his goons that he had set the fire at Turkey Point. And lied to the police so that Allison would stop loving CryBaby and go back to him.
That figures, you low-down son of a... industrialist!
Baldwin! Brandish, I hereby
wait, Judge! Not yet! Please! I'll surrender in a minute, but first I gotta fix things with my best girl.
I'll give you 1 minute.
Allison, I know why you might be upset with me right now, but remember, we got officially engaged on the actual radio. And I know I'm a better man and a much better musician than this no-good thug, who I might point out has just done time in jail. So I hereby challenge you, Cry Baby Walker. To a musical battle! Right here, right now, the winner gets Allison!
doll. Yeah. She has to choose you.
Well, ready? Go!
Isn't this a little bit on the insane side?
I say go! I need room.
Listen to this amazing offer. Someone to worship and adore. He doesn't slice or dice, but he's nastily dressed and nice. How much would you pay? But wait, there's more. Also, I'll throw in my devotion, plus this limited edition of my art. All this stunning merchandise can be yours to look impressed. We will never part. I'll soon go away. Don't delay. Act today.
All right, you asked for it. Forgive me, ladies. Well, I put him out of my misery. You make me shiver, make me quiver, make me shake in my shoes. I'm in a tizzy, feeling dizzy like I drank too much booze. You put a strain on my brain, think I'm going insane. You got me howling like a dummy, got locked out in the rain.
Transgression and the evil that's involved was a problem of forgiveness.
Well, you can